dear cause, precious one. Hallelujah. The Lord is good and his mercy endureth forever. And we just ended with our last series.
That was yesterday when we took the last part of the Christ life. So today we are in church and we are having prayer meeting, but then I would be giving a short word to bless as many who will be joining us online before we go into prayers here in church. Hallelujah. So I want to share what titled The Word of Faith. The Word of Faith. And this is really, really special to us because today we are celebrating our 14th year as a ministry. Today it marks the exact date, 14th year, but actually we would be having the anniversary service to celebrate this by June. That will be June 28th. But today we're just taking note of what God has been to us and how faithful he has been. Hallelujah. So we'll be hearing God's word today, the word of faith. Hallelujah. Amen. The word of faith. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And I want us to turn to the book of Hebrews. The book of Hebrews. We'll be seeing Hebrews chapter 11. And this chapter actually is the hallmark of faith. Here you find so many men and women of faith who live their life in faith and they obtain promises. Hallelujah. According to scriptures. So we're going to take a look at the word of faith. Hallelujah. So let's see Hebrews chapter 11. I will read from verse 1. He said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. I like when the scripture comments and he said, now, in a nutshell, the Lord, through his word, is letting us know that this is not for the sweet by and by. This promise or the word that we see is not something that is being put forward for the future, but it is for the now. For the believer, this is for the now. Faith is for the now. He said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence. The evidence. Hallelujah. The evidence. The margin puts it, now faith is the realization of things hoped for, the conviction. So when you say the evidence in the King James, the margin puts it better or lets us know what it means by that word substance and evidence. Substance is talking about the realization. Faith is the substance. Faith is the realization of things hoped for. And the evidence, which means the conviction that we have in our spirit. Hallelujah. Because faith is something spiritual. You have faith in your spirit, but the result is made manifest in the physical. Hallelujah. In other words, faith is you seeing with the eyes of your spirit what the eyes cannot behold. Hallelujah. I like the way Pastor Chris once defined faith. He said faith is the positive response of the human spirit to the word of God. Faith is the positive response of the human spirit to the word of God. In other words, you are saying yes once the word of God comes to you. You respond positively. You act upon the word as though it was true because it is true. Hallelujah. So, having seen what faith is, because when we're talking about the word of faith, the natural question one wants to ask, what is faith? So, we're just taking a look at how scripture describes and defines faith as a substance of things hoped for, the evidence or the conviction of things not seen with the optical eyes, and I share also with you Pastor Chris's definition of faith being the positive response of the human spirit to the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to see further. Verse 2. He said, for by it, by what? By this faith, by it the elders, for by it the elders obtained, they obtained a good report. Hallelujah. They obtained. They took a hold of. They possessed a good report. The elders, they not only believed, but they took a hold of it. They obtained. They got a report that was good as their personal possession and testimony. You know, the man or woman who live by faith is the man or woman we call the believer. And the believer is a possessor. When somebody says, I'm a believer, it means you are a haver. You are one who possesses that which the word of God talks about concerning you. You take a hold of it. You might have not seen it with your optical eyes, but you possess it first in your spirit. So the believer is a haver, is a possessor. Say, Pastor, what do you mean? We see explained in details with a very popular scripture which many of us knew while we were growing up. My dad actually taught us. One of those scriptures my dad taught us to memorize was John 3:16. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten what? Son. And he didn't end there. Because yes, those days we are young, we chant it. No, we just chant it away. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. But there's such a deep revelation in this scripture. He said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth, that's where the believer comes in. That's where you and I comes in. He said that whosoever, without restriction, whosoever, that's the man or woman who is born again, whosoever, that's the man or woman who is a new creation in Christ, whosoever believeth in him should not perish. So it's a law of the spirit, which even the devil and his agents know, that whoever believe should not perish. Whoever believe should not perish. Hallelujah. Oh, I wish that so many would be awakened to this revelation, that whoever believe cannot perish. Whoever believe truly in God, in his word, you cannot perish. It doesn't matter what viruses is moving around. It doesn't matter how many devils are spreading it. Whoever truly believes should not perish. It's a spiritual law. It's a law by the spirit. Whoever believes should not perish. But let's see the part that I really want to dwell on that relates to what we are seeing today. Whoever believes should not perish, but have. So the believer is a haver. The believer is a haver. That whoever believes should not perish, but have, but possess eternal life. But possess eternal life. That's why it must be so clear to you that the day and moment you got born again, you have eternal life. You don't wait to get to heaven before you have it. You know, you ask some believers, supposedly believers in quote, you ask them, are you very sure
that if Jesus comes right now, that you will be caught up with him?
You say, Pastor, you know that thing is until the last day, nobody can really tell.
Hallelujah. When somebody talks that way, then that man, that woman needs to be saved. Because you can't be saved without knowing it. You can't be saved without knowing that you are saved. So when you're talking that way, that until that last day when Jesus comes, that's when we will know, then you are not saved. So it's better you get on the right side.
Hallelujah.
You can't be saved without knowing it.
Hallelujah.
You can't receive eternal life without knowing it.
Say, Pastor, but I thought it's when we get to heaven that we start eternal life.
No. It's the day and moment you got born again. The day and moment you confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior. That's what will be seen in 2 Corinthians 5:17. He said, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All these are what pass away, and behold, all things have become new. The transformation is instant. You don't wait to get to heaven before you are transformed. Yes, habits, the transformation is in your spirit. It takes place instantly. Your outward look may remain the same. If you were shot before, you may remain shot, unfortunately.
Hallelujah.
But in the spirit, you are tall.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you were fair before, you may remain fair. If you had dark in complexion before, you may remain dark. But you know what? Gloriously, your spirit begins to glow. Why? Because the transformation is in your spirit. If any man, if any woman is in Christ, he is a new creation. So the transformation takes place in my spirit. Instantly, you receive eternal life into your spirit. The life of God in your heart. Because Christ came into the quarters of your heart to make his abode. And he came with his own life. And that life that Jesus came with is Zoe. Eternal life, divine life, everlasting life came to reside in the quarters of your heart. So you receive eternal life the very moment you got born again. When you get to heaven, you simply continue.
Hallelujah.
You simply continue in that life. But you receive the life instantly. And that's what we mean. Or that's what the scripture means when it says, he that believes should not perish, but have. But have. You possess the life instantly from the moment and time you got born again. So the believer is a power. The believer is a possessor. He's a possessor of eternal verity. Hallelujah, of eternal life. This is what is called the new creation realities, which we are supposed to live in as God's people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's unfortunate that so many have not come to this consciousness, but I believe so much that we have come to the time and age where the church of God is awakening to these realities. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the believer is a harbor. He's a possessor. Then, Pastor, if I'm a harbor and a possessor, how am I supposed to see this life manifest in my body, in my life, in my affairs, in my ministry, in my health, in my family? How am I supposed to see the realities of this life? You have to see the realities of this life by speaking. Because faith speaks. Remember, we're talking about the word of faith. Faith speaks. The man or woman who has faith is called a believer. But he's not supposed to be quiet. He is a possessor. Yet he's not supposed to be quiet about what he has possessed or what he has at his possession. But he's supposed to speak it forth. You have it in your spirit. But you begin to release it in words. And that brings it to pass in the natural. That brings it to pass in the natural. We see that happen. Even when God created the heavens and earth, the Bible said, and when God suddenly came into, when God showed up, everything around the world was without form and void. The earth was without form and void. And if God were to be like some of us, he could have been complaining about the situation. He could have been complaining about how the whole place was a mess, and how the whole place was full of waters, and how it was all void and without nothing. But God was not to be moved by what was available
of what was to be seen
with the physical eyes, but rather he was to speak what he believed into existence. Hallelujah. He had this consciousness and this belief of an exact picture of what he wanted in his world. And the Bible says, and God said, let there be light. The Spirit of God was already hovering around the face of the water. And when God said, let there be light, the Holy Ghost, that is the doer of the things of God. That's the Holy Ghost. He is the doer of the things of God. And when God said, let there be light, the doer of the things of God brought it to pass. Hallelujah. And you know what? The same Holy Ghost is still hovering around in the life of every believer today, waiting for us to release the word. The word of faith. Hallelujah. So faith must not be silent. Faith must speak. Hallelujah. You possess whatever promises that the Lord has given you as a child of God in your spirit. You have it in your spirit, but you don't just need it to remain in your spirit. You need to call it forth to the physical. Hallelujah. And that requires the word of faith that you speak. Hallelujah. So you begin to release words. You're not supposed to be quiet. You're not supposed to be quiet. And this we see in 2 Corinthians 4 verse 13. We're going to take a look at that scripture. And that's what will be leading us into prayers today. The word of faith. Amen. Who release words. Words of power. Hallelujah. And this brings about changes in our life, in our circumstances, in our health, in our situation, in our family, in the concerning your business, concerning your job. You need to speak the word of faith. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 13. I'll read because of time. Hallelujah. The word of faith. The word of faith. 2 Corinthians 4 verse 13. Hallelujah. I read. He said, we having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believe and therefore have I spoken. We also believe and therefore speak. So here I was supposed by the Spirit of God was related to the church of God that the same faith with which great men and women in the scripture saw great things come to be, that same faith that was written about in scriptures, that it was written that I believe and therefore have I spoken. And he said to them also, we also believe and therefore we do what? We release words. So that tells you that it is an established principle in the kingdom. Whatever you believe, you are supposed to speak. Whatever you believe, you are supposed to speak. And sometimes, when you think, oh, maybe I don't believe anything, I won't speak anything. Oftentimes, even when you don't speak consciously, you may end up speaking unconsciously, and those things may not be of benefit. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. So, it is very important. It is very important that you, it is very important that you learn to speak. He said, I believe, therefore have I spoken. I believe, therefore have I spoken. So what is it that you believe? What is it that you believe about your head? What is it that you believe about your business? What is it that you believe about your family? What is it that you believe about your home? What is it that you believe about your ministry? I believe and therefore have I spoken. We believe, therefore we speak. Hallelujah. So we're going to have a time of prayer this evening. We're going to speak forth what we believe. That which we have in our spirit. That which we've been given by the Lord. That we possess in our spirit. But it's not enough that this is in our spirit. It's time to release it. It's time to speak it forth. Hallelujah. And we've been, the Lord has been faithful for us here in Healing Grace Christian Assembly for 14 years. And most of the things that we see the Lord do were things that He laid first and foremost in our hearts. But we spoke them into existence. And we saw them work out. We saw them come into pass. Hallelujah. When He gave us visions, we spoke them forth. Not many believed at first, but now many have seen the light. Hallelujah. And you know, this is an eternal principle that operates in the kingdom. So the same thing applies to you. It doesn't matter the dreams that the Lord has laid in your heart. Maybe nobody believes in it.
Maybe nobody encouraged you about it, but begin to speak about it. Continue to speak about it. Don't give up. You know, speak it out until you see the manifestation of the glory of God concerning that vision. For we believe, and therefore we speak. And what is it that we speak? We speak the word of faith. Hallelujah. God bless you. This is Pastor Peter Ashazobo signing off for those joining us on Facebook and YouTube. God bless you. See you tomorrow evening. God bless you. Bye.
Hallelujah.
So.